Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Wending Mai. I'm a research fellow in University of Electronic Science and Technology of China. My supervisor is Yifan Chen, and it's a pity that he cannot attend this meeting because of visa issue. I would like to thank Professor Palos to invite us here and have we in this project. Today I will give some introductions about the clinical pathways in China because we want this DeMoStroke project to be commercialized and gain to market in China's market. And I will give some to introduce some classifications of the medical equipment in China and the registration process of CFDA. And we have a manufacturer partner in China with ET Medical, and I will introduce some information about this company. So first of all, I would like to introduce the university. It's a long name, so I just, to be short, is we will call it UGSTC. UGSTC was specifically in electronic engineering, but now it's aiming to some multidisciplinary universities, and is aim to be research oriented. There are many students here, and among them there are many talented students. And in our team, we have about 5 or 7 graduate students working with us, and they are very helpful to this project. To talk about the clinical pathway in China, we have. Generally, we have 2 sections. One is about the technical issue here, and I believe a lot of talk has been given in this morning. And UESTC also done some work in this, and a few work was integrated in King's work, presentation in the morning. So in the afternoon, I will focus my presentation on the administrative processing in China to get the clinical pathway. To get the clinical pathway in China, we have to firstly define the classification of this medical equipment, whether it's class 2 or class 3 based on the hazard or level of standards. Of CFDA, and we need a registered manufacturer to fill these applications. In this slide, we can see these 2 sections separated, but actually they have some stuff to couple with each other. For example, for the administrative processing, we would like this. Product with is safety is safe and effective and robust, because we don't want the hospital install their equipment and broken 2 weeks later. So to be robust, there are some issues we have to solve in the technical way. So these 2 sections actually can couple with each other to get this administrative process pass through. In China, all kinds of medical equipment are classified into 3 classes based on their level of hazard. The simplest equipment is like the patient bed or nurse tray, which has low hazard to their patient health or safety. So the regulation standard is no standard. And for equipment with major hazard, it is class 2 equipment. But for equipment with high S hazard, like the equipment to detect tumor or other equipment, is classified as a class 3 and has a highly standard. This is a administrative processing of the registration of medical devices in China. This is a processing of the class 2, and we can notice that it needs approval only by the province department of FDA. And and we have to get the province approval, and then we can start the technical review or assessment and blah blah. And generally it will take about 1.5 years to complete to finish this process. And this is our registration for class 3. And we can notice here that this application has to be approved by the National Bureau. So class 3 is much more difficult than class 2 equipment. But officially, the time span is the same, also 1.5 years. To make a quick summary of this registration process, we hope that the stroke detection device that we are developing, we hope to be classified as a second class, because it is easier and has lower regulation standard. However, because stroke is a very dangerous symptom, and so maybe stroke detection device is most probably be classified as a third class equipment, which has a highest standard. We can only start the registration process only after the sample machine prepared, and it will take, officially it will take 1.5 years, but maybe longer than expected. And this process is usually conducted by some agency companies, because they may have some better government relationships with FDA, and they are doing business about on this. Actually, many experienced manufacturers are hiring agent to complete this process. So we have talked about the classification registration of the FDA, but to fill this application, we cannot do this alone. We have to cooperate with some partners, which is registered manufacturer in China, because only registered manufacturer have the access to fill the application. And the FDA have different standard for the registered manufacturers according to their classifications of their fabricated equipment. For example, if a company holds their class one certification, they can only fail the registration for only class 1 equipment. Only the class 3 manufacturer can fill the application for class 3 equipment. So our potential partner manufacturer, ET Medical, is a class 3 register manufacturer in China. It holds the highest certification in China, so we may need their cooperation to fill these applications. UT Medical is a medical equipment company, including doing some screening, prevention, and treatment, and to the cancer prevention and treatment. It's wholly owned by the Zhongxin Holding, Zhongzhu Holding Company. And he has done some many, he has made some medical equipment, and is committed to becoming a leader of the whole cancer industry chain in China. Right now, his headquarters is located in Shenzhen, but has two branches in Beijing and Xi'an, and has numerous addresses in China. He got a lot of ownership in China, like the National High-Tech Enterprise and other other prices. As I see, it's a class 3 in the instrument manufacturer, which is the highest level. So they have the access to fail the application of the stroke detection equipment to the CFDA. So they has a lot of owner prices. They asked me to put them here. I would just skip it. Okay. And there are more owners. And this are the products they have already put into market, including some ultrasound diagnosis and radiotherapy and many products. And what I mean to say is they are experienced about the registration process, and they have gone through this processing, and may help us to get through these pathways in China. To get through the registration process, ET Medical cooperates over many hospitals in China. There is over 35 hospitals across 30 cities in China. There are reports other cities that this hospital located. So ET Medical could also help us to start the clinical trial, but there are still some challenges about the clinical trial. Because the end of last year, there is a gene modified fetal child trial conducted by Jiang Kuihe, and it's very controversial because they modify the human's gene. So after that affair, the CFDA, especially its department in Shenzhen, is very cautious to approve new clinical trial applications. So that is a bad news for us. Maybe we will face some difficulties which we didn't expect it earlier. Unlike brain cancer, which deteriorates very slow, stroke deteriorates very fast, maybe in several hours. Therefore, it might be hard to persuade their patients to take her precious time to take some extra trial. So these are some challenges we might face. In conclusion, the DeMoStroke equipment is most probably classified as a class 3 equipment in China, which has a higher standard and it's hard to get the registration process. And this registration process is time consuming, about 1.5 years in official, and it's somewhat complex with the government relationships, and this time also depends on the efficiency of the government officer. So generally we will need some help. We will need help from some agency companies, maybe hire them to fill these applications after the when we are ready for the market. For the registration, we'll need a certificate of manufacturer partner to fill this application, because this certificated manufacturer may have many certifications like ISO certification or safety certification, which we don't hold. And ET Medical, our partner, fulfills this requirement and is familiar with the clinical pathway in China, and we are happy to have these partners, and we are looking forward to our success of this project. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay. Are there any questions or comments regarding presentation?
I'm just wondering about the manufacturing.
Do you want to have the microphone?
I'm just wondering about the manufacturing partner require and certification. Is it for the manufacturing partner should be in China itself?
The manufacturer should be registered in CFDA, and CFDA is a Chinese bureau, so I don't know if it allows foreign companies to be registered, but in maybe more than 90% is local companies.
Right. Okay.
Thank you for your question.
Okay, can I also ask, you mentioned that maybe that the in Shenzhen, maybe right now it's a difficult. How much variation is there from region to region about? So could there be that some that there's, you know, different.
Yeah, actually.
And how would that work on the national level then? Is there? Do you know?
Actually, we have this picture to show that right now Shenzhen is very cautious about the to approve the clinical trial, but. But the ET Medical has more than 35 cooperating hospitals, and this in this place we can also fill applications in these places.
But the permissions are given hold only for a local.
No. We hope to be classified as a class 2.
Yes.
And for class 2, we only need approval from the province, like Sichuan province or Beijing or Shanghai. This is local province approval. But most probably, we will be classified as a class 3. So we will need a national approval. It's for all of this country.
Okay, so you're saying that if it was a class 2, then it could be a local promo? Okay, yeah, in that sense. Okay.
The local is easier.
Yes.
Yeah. We have seen this morning very interesting comparison from country to country for some disease, mortality rates, and so on. Is it possible, would it be possible to observe a classification concerning the easiness of conducting clinical trials worldwide?
Thank you for questioning. Actually, I am a research fellow in USTC, so I'm not 100% familiar with the administration of CFDA, then it's why we need some agency companies. But what I believe is because ET Medical has made in cooperating hospitals diverse in this whole country, so the diversity of this clinical trial may be considered by the CFDA. So I don't know if I answer your questions.
Yes.
Can I just comment? I think the way in China is working is that I think you don't have to worry too much. They're running many trials, and the key thing is that we have to find a good company to work with. So the ET Medical seems quite a credible kind of company. They got many years experience. They registered many different medical equipment. That's it. And doesn't really matter, because the ethic issue in Shenzhen, what happened, that should be the way that we have to be, you know, every application should go through the process. What happened for the genetic baby thing is that modified because they fake the ethic approval. That's the illegal.
Yes.
Here we have nothing to hide. Yeah. Everything goes through, and they normally they will go to the agency, but just be aware, and they take time.
Yeah.
Probably 1 year and a half.
Okay, thank you. All right, great. Thank you very much again.
Thank you.
Okay. And now we have one more talk who's going to be given up. Professor Sklar, who's also at King's College. She doesn't work in microimaging, but she works on an interesting area in decision systems for, so it's more, I guess, AI. It's AI. Artificial intelligence, so I think it's complementary to what we discussed also in the morning. And they've done a nice project which had stroke as a case study. So